So today we are going to talk about how to set your camera in your scene and how to make Playblast. So let's get started. You have to go to create camera and camera. Once you click on it, you see the camera. Few things you need to know about. This is your focal length. How to look through camera. There are two options. You can set your scene. Let me just give a basic setup to the scene. You go to camera and you can see here camera minus Z. This is your camera. Now it's, you can rotate it, you can move as you want, just like your view. There are a few settings you need to take care of. This is your scene. So how much exactly visible in your camera? So there is your setting. Resolution gate. This is what you need to keep it on. And the next option is automatically on gate mask. Make sure you need to keep both options on. Resolution gate and gate mask. Whatever is inside your this white box is inside your camera. This will be your rendered image. So make sure you do that. So this is going to be visible. So what's my action? This is my action. This is my topmost frame. So I'll just set it accordingly where it's going. So now there is a lot of blank space here. I'll try to get it in center, all the action. Little bit. So getting the best action there is the right way. So it's pretty much good. Once you're done setting your camera, there is a lock button, lock camera. Once you click on it, and there is another option, select camera. Once you select your camera, you see everything is gray here. That means you can't move your camera now. So this is very important to lock your camera. Once you lock your camera, it won't be moving. This is very important. There is a chance you might mess up with your camera while animating. So this is good to know. Here you can see your resolution. How to set your resolution. Another thing, you can see display render settings. Click on it, a render setting tab will open. Don't do anything, just go to the common and go below. This is your image size. So here we can decide what's the resolution we are going to use. The common HD resolution is 1920x1080. So we are using that. This is the most common, 720 and 540p is also there. So this is our camera ready. Next is how to make Playblast. So this is important. You need to set your time range, which area you want to play blast. You need to go and right click. You do. So now you once you go to the Playblast option box, go right click and go to the Playblast option box. Once you go there, you see a lot of options. I'll just do the reset. Okay, good. This is your default settings, AVI. So I won't recommend to do AVI because AVI are quite heavy. You will see QT and image. QT will only appears, that means QuickTime. So QuickTime will only appears when you have QuickTime installed in your PC. If you don't have QuickTime installed, you won't see QuickTime option. So we start with the QuickTime first. You go to QuickTime, or the most common is QuickTime H264. You do the quality 100. Display size. Now you have 1920x1080 settings. So you do from render settings. Scale 0.5. This means it will scale the entire scene into half. I'll leave it 0.5. Frame padding, this is for images. Like how many number of images you are saving. Like for example, your scene is bouncing ball and you are taking image sequence. So it will be making images for every frame. And the images will be saved as bouncing ball _001. So there will be four numbers at the end. So this is what decides the total number of frame number. Okay, we are going to remove temporary file. If you do it like this, it will go into temp. So I'll just do it right now. Here your Playblast automatically opened. This is my animation. This is how playing, this is displaying everything. Okay, so where does it actually went? Blast 12. It went to, here you can see your path. Result, C drive, user, user, app, data, local, temp, blast 12. You go, press window R, and you press the shortcut, percent, T-E-M-P, percent. Press enter. You set up your folder as date modified. The last thing you have just modified, you can see the time 2032 blast 12. This is my Playblast here. The size is 234 KB. Because we are using QuickTime, it's 234 KB. Let's take the other options. I go to AVI. So most of you not going to have QT option, there's going to do AVI. Let's do AVI IYUV codec. Let's do the Playblast. This is also done. Blast 8 AVI. I'll open the temp file. Now see, there is a huge size gap. 88 MB. It's going to be 4 times if you're going to do 1920. And as the time increases, the file size goes way beyond. So the AVI file is really went heavy. That's why we use QuickTime. In some cases, you might need to do image sequence. You can try that too. I'll just do a quick image sequence. And there you can see your format, JPG, PNG, TGA. So JPG and PNG are most common. I'll keep it 0.5 scale just to keep make it fast. Playblast. So remember guys, we are working on temporary. By default is using fcheck to play the image sequence. And everything again went to the temp. So there are, it went in strange because of the naming and the timing. I'll do it again, detail. I'll do it by the name. So that's blast B. Here it is. From 1 to 120. Total 120 frames into images. If you open any single image, that's the frame. So this is your three types of Playblast. What's next? Playblast settings. Okay, view and show ornament. When I turn it off, you won't be seeing any. Wait a second, let's go to back to QuickTime. Once I turn it off, you won't be seeing any extra information like this. Okay, that's because of this. Okay, the codec is PNG. It didn't change. I'll do that again. Remove temporary. Now I do save file. Let's remove this. Then there is come save file. So where is going to be? It's going to be now in a different path. If this file is off, it will go to temp. If you check this on, you get the file name. File name PB test, and you can decide the path where it can go. By default, it goes to your project folder. The project folder, you can just copy your path from here. Where is it? Is it in document, Maya, projects, default, movie? This is where all your Playblast went. So test PB. Here your path, just do that PB. Okay, now this is good. So only the resolution came and all the information are gone now. So why they've gone? Because I turn off ornaments. If you turn on ornaments, you will get your information. Other information, camera name, whatever is on your screen. So if you turn it off, you will only get the resolution. That is good. So what left? What left is now, what is if you don't have QuickTime, you have AVI and you use IYU codec, Toshiba, there's lots of codec, I use IYUV and this is really heavy. So what else, you have to send your Playblast across some platform and you have to mail it, you have to send it to your client. So what will happen? Let's check. Let's do a full scale Playblast and see the size. Okay, this is our AVI, where it is? It is in document, Maya, project, default, movie, test PB. Now this is 355 MB file. You can't send your 304 MB file for your review animation. That takes a lot of time. So there is a plugin, an application, Handbrake. You can use Handbrake, you can download Handbrake just from their site, handbrake.fr, and this is pretty handy. I'll just show you how to use Handbrake. So once you open, you drag and drop here, nothing you have to do, it's by default MP4, M4V, and this is your codec, H.264, 30 fps, you don't mess with anything, just start encoding. Where it goes, video test PB. The first time you open, you have to give it a path. I already have given it a path, so it took in the older path here. What's the size now? 62 kb. And if I play it, oh, it's the same size. So it reduced a lot of size and it came into 62 kb. So this is good. I'll leave the link in description so you can find it. It's help for your animation and presentation. Okay guys, thank you for joining today. We'll see with more tips and tutorials in the next video. Thank you.